get in the covers.
I'm on my own again, complete solitude. I don't even know where the next person is, other than the road, not too far away. I haven't been alone since before Christmas. I've been camping with friends, went to a couple events in Quartzsite, and then of course my 2 months in Baja with my Baja buddies. I was a little afraid that I would forget how to be alone.
Are you okay?
But I gotta admit, it feels good.
Uh-oh. Okay, what did you do?
Uh-oh. What did we do? What happened? Did you hurt your leg coming off the step?
Is it okay?
I enjoyed hanging out with my friends in Baja. It was nice to have people to share things with. But there's just something about being alone. It's really the only time I'm completely 100% myself and at ease and comfortable and relaxed. I don't know if other people can understand that. It's not like I'm not relaxed and not comfortable and not at ease and not myself with other people. There's just a sense of freedom. A sense of contentment. Being out here completely alone again, it's like wrapping your favorite blanket around yourself, snuggling in and being comfy and cozy. It feels like home. Out here, it's easy. The mountains, the birds, the plants. None of them care if I talk too much, or if I don't talk enough, or if I stick my foot in my mouth, if I say something stupid. None of that matters out here. The mountains and the Cholla don't expect me to be anybody but me, with all my flaws and all my faults. You see that circle of rocks? Looks like a clearing for somebody to sleep. Look, fire pit. Setting out on my own, alone in nature, my first big hike on the John Muir Trail is where I began to heal, where I found myself. The first place I ever felt safe. Excuse me. Where'd my dog go? As I embark on my 9th year of solo RV living, I can wander out into the desert, into the wilderness, into the forest, alone again. Feeling content that I was able to spend some time with some good people and have community and have some fun and some laughs and some adventures together. My 8 years of near total solitude have been a gift. I can now recognize that I can go out and do peopling. I can enjoy the laughter and the community and the adventures. And then I can go home to my safe and free place. That home is within myself, alone with my dog in Mother Nature.
7. Tomorrow I hope to do some more exploring, but I'll have to see what the weather does. Day 8, I regret to inform you that I have another riddle for you to endure. Here it is. On you I float, I walk on water, trudging after the mink and the otter, clicking and clacking in frozen sand, drifting across a desolate land. Hours we'll spend bound to each other, till I grow weary of my wooden brother. I'll take you off for a while, I think, but quickly recall how fast I sink.
You look so cute. You look so cute.